gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair. I'm gonna wash that man right out of my hair and send him on his way.
Hi everybody, this is Tom Tierney back here in the Sony Music Archives. Today I'm gonna take you back to talk about the history of the Sony Music Photo Library, and we'll look at a few cool things just to give you a sense of what we have, why we have it, and where it all comes from. Columbia Records and RCA Records, obviously, prior to the merger in 2005, were completely independent companies, the two giants of the industry. And independent of one another, somewhat coincidentally, both companies in around the years 1948-49 began their own photo libraries, which means that at that point, instead of just hiring photographers and getting images to use for their very various promotional campaigns or what have you, they actually hired staff photographers who worked for the companies and photographed every aspect of the operations of the companies. So in addition to photographing the artists and recording sessions and concerts, these photographers would also take photos of the pressing plants and executive headshots and the company softball game. And we're lucky that the Sony Music Archives now archives all of those original negatives back to about 1949. They dovetail very beautifully with our other holdings so that when we look at a particular recording or a particular Broadway show, we can look at how all of the information is integrated. And I thought we would go back to the very beginning of the photo library and talk about the musical South Pacific. Now, South Pacific, we have this document right here, which is an original recording document from 1949. Sadly, over the years, unfortunately, for whatever reason, maybe even as far back as the 50s, the heavy use of this document had led to a little tear, a little missing part of the document, but luckily we still have it and it's very safe now. South Pacific is really, in many ways, a perfect show to talk about in reference to the Sony Music Archives because it comes along at two very critical junctures. First of all, in terms of Sony Music, it comes along right at the beginning of our photo library. In terms of the record industry in particular and Columbia Records, it comes along at the very birth of the 33 and a third long playing LP. Now, South Pacific was, you could say, the first cast recording that really took advantage of the 33 and a third format. It came out in mid-1949, fewer than 12 months after the initial release of the LPs in June of 1948. Again, we have here the contract for the recording session for the cast album for South Pacific. The contract itself is dated April 1st. And there's various sort of royalty information and management information, but the recording session itself, as it says here, took place on April 18th, 1949. Very shortly thereafter, the LP came out. Probably the first Broadway cast recording LP that really took advantage of the format. Just for fun, I pulled out this little thing, which just goes to show you how mixed up the formats were in those days. In addition to the LP, there was of course the 78 RPM box and this, which was the 45 RPM box. Columbia started putting out 45s in 1950 and shortly thereafter started making 45 boxes to replicate the 33 and a third albums. And this is the 45 RPM cast recording of South Pacific. It's a box that has four 45 RPM records in it. Getting back to the photo library, as we said, it was right at this time where both Columbia and RCA started their photo libraries. I'd like to show you some excerpts from the photo session for South Pacific because they're really incredible. This is maybe my favorite contact sheet. Certainly one of my favorite contact sheets from South Pacific. Probably one of my favorite contact sheets from the entire library. And in our photo library, we use these contact sheets so researchers can match the negatives against the against the contacts. So obviously, if you've ever looked at a negative, it's very, very tough to tell what's on there. So this is what we use to make sure what's on the negative. And in this particular contact sheet, you can see these really incredible portraits of Mary Martin, Richard Rodgers, and lots of other individuals from the cast. Ezio Pinza there, various management and record producers, Goddard Lieberson, who produced the album, as well as all of most of the other Columbia cast albums all the way into the 70s. At this point, he was vice president of Columbia, and shortly later into the 50s, he became the president of Columbia. Lots of other great images from the South Pacific Photo Library. These are the actual recording sessions at the microphone at Columbia Studios. One more neat little photo from the South Pacific file is this one, which is about a month after the recording session for South Pacific in April of 1949. This is May of 1949. Miss Juanita Hall, who portrayed Bloody Mary in South Pacific and won the Tony for her for that role. And here she is doing some press for the album release of South Pacific from May 49, talking to Mr. Stearns, announcer for New York City's beloved WQXR. So even in those days, the artists were going around plugging LPs, and we have an example here, not just to show the photo library is, like I said, recording sessions and portraits, but also following artists around, doing press, cocktail parties, backstage stuff. So the photo library has all aspects of this type of cast recording, this type of release, and it sort of follows them through the cycle of the product. Thanks for watching. This is Tom Tierney here in the Sony Music Archives, and I'll see you next time.